Hello and welcome to our new session of Fashion Premier League. My name is Taruna and today I have a very special guest with me who defies all the odds and making it true that age is just a number. He's inspiring people of all age groups with his stylish demeanor and setting up a unique benchmark in the fashion industry. A very warm welcome to Mr. Dinesh Mohan.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dinesh, for joining with us today.
You're welcome.
Thank you. So how are you doing today?
I'm doing very well, as usual, on top of the world. I keep my energy level flowing on top every time, every day. So yeah, it's routine for me.
That's good. So starting this round of conversation, my first question to you is, at the age of 62, where most of the people think about retirement, and here you are giving tough competition to the youngsters. So how do you feel about that?
I mean, I'm living my life for myself, for my sake. And I never bother that whether I'm giving competition to people of my own age group or younger people or older than me. I just take each day as it comes and try to give it my best. So that's it. Not competing with anybody, not trying to show somebody down. Just trying to live my own life and make a mark for myself. Yeah. That is what my intention is.
That's good. And you have a mantra, live life to its fullest.
Correct. Yes, I do have that. Yes, each yeah. moment.
Okay. So you are a registered model, only registered model who started his career at the age of 57 in India. So how did you feel when you first walked the ramp?
Yeah. I felt out of place because, you know, my very first experience was with Amazon Fashion Week, which is FDCI's event, and that happened in February 2018. So that was my first walk, and everybody was very young and very tall, and they were very well built, and, you know, all had dark hair and, you know, as young models are, boys and girls, and nobody else of my age group. But then I thought, let me use this as a trump card, because, you know, in the crowd of sheep, a lion will always get noticed. So, and that happened. When I walked on the ramp for the first time there, there was huge thunder and applause, and everybody, you know, appreciated my look and the effort. That here is a person who at this age is trying to make a mark for himself. So I was appreciated a lot.
Yeah. So do you felt it like challenging while working with the young models? Was it challenging for you?
No, not with young models, but walking in itself was a challenge for me, because I had spent most of my years prior to my becoming a model and an actor as a handicapped person. I could not walk for around 5 to 7 years, and was homebound and inside my room and totally reclusive and antisocial. So the real challenge was that, will I be able to, you know, because I had undergone a treatment and therapy, physiotherapy, and then I had started walking again. So it was a huge challenge that in front of so many people, will I be able to walk properly or not? Will I be able to carry it off, or will the consciousness which was there in my mind reflect onto the audience? But none of that happened, because the moment I stepped my foot, first step on the ramp, and I was like, you know, I was born to do this, and the thunder only encouraged me to walk more proudly and yes. But I don't care whom I am. I've said it earlier also. Whom I am walking with, who else are there in the show. I know what I am. I know what I bring to a show. And I don't care whether they make me walk with an ant or with an elephant. It doesn't make any difference to me at all.
Yeah. So, as you told just now about your state before coming into the modeling world. So keeping that in my mind, I have a question for you. You went through depression for 12 long years, and then on 12th of February 2009, a day came into your life that changed everything. So what inspired you that day?
Yeah, lots of things. One that I was very fed up of, you know, being in that state. Because as a young person, you know, we all have dreams. We all dream that our lives will be this and we'll. My only dream in life was to travel and to be happy, you know, because money, I had no problem with money because my family was good and we had money in family and all that. So my aim was to be happy and to travel. But sadly, that did not happen. And I was homebound and in depression and then lots of ailments and overweight and things like that. So it was an urge from inside very passionately that I should go out now and try to fulfill my, you know, youthful dream that I used to see in my youth and see the world, travel around a lot, start with the city that I was living in because I had not seen even that city much because I shifted to Gurgaon, Delhi in 2004, but then lots of problems started and things and I was homebound and there were visits to all the hospitals and all the doctors and so many medicines. I knew the chemist stores were there, all the chemists knew me, all the doctors knew me, but other than that, I had no social life. So my only feeling was that I should now step out as a normal part of society. So this is what encouraged me to, you know, get up and get going and do something in life.
Do something. Yeah. Yes. So from this, my next question to you is, there are people out there of your age who also wants to pursue the career that you are pursuing right now. They have the same dream. So what kind of message would you like to convey them so that they can live up to their dreams?
Yeah, and I'm so happy about this fact that I have, you know, opened a kind of Pandora's box, so to say, that people of my age group and older than me, and even people in their 40s, because in our country, you know, when you hit 35 or 40, everybody starts thinking that now life is over and, you know, there is boredom and what to do. But I'm very happy that my success story has given encouragement to a lot of people of this age group and even younger age group and older age group to get up and do something. Not everybody can be, unfortunately, a model or an actor because that's not possible in everyone's case. But everyone should try to excel in something, in some area of interest, maybe painting or dramatics or traveling or, you know, there is so much of blogging going on these days. There's food blogging, there's travel blogging, style blogging, fashion blogging. So many avenues for people to excel in. And I'm very happy that people of all age groups are now gaining prominence all over in India. So that's a very nice feeling.
Okay. So coming to the modeling world, my next question to you is, have you ever gone through any kind of odd situation or have you ever faced any kind of challenge in the modeling industry?
Not exactly like that. Challenge, I don't know what you mean by challenge, but I have faced rejections and I don't call them rejections, but they are a matter of your being fit or not being fit for a particular designer or a particular project. So that happens in this line very often. Even now, I am rejected every day and people think that I am successful and, you know, I am this celebrity or whatever. The casting people and the directors don't look at you like that. If you fit a project, they take you. If you don't fit a project, but in my case, I'm very hopeful. I'm very positive. And every time I'm rejected from one project, I am offered at least 5 better projects than that project. So destiny has always helped me. And so I don't take these challenges. You know, for me, the real challenge in life was to get up and get going. That was a challenge. That was to lose that weight and to fight depression. These are very minor things. In this line, there are no challenges which are worth my attention, you know.
So is there anything you feel that should be changed in the fashion industry?
Yes. You know, what I feel, everybody thinks that only successful models and actors are there in this, and it's very difficult for youngsters to or strugglers to find their place. But it's just the opposite. Everybody in this industry is trying to cut costs even before the lockdown and pandemic happened, when this industry had a lot of money going, even then everybody shied away from successful established models like me, because they don't want to pay me a huge amount of money. They would rather go in for a fresh pace and pay him or her or not pay at all and make them walk. So it's challenging even for the strugglers, because they have to do most of their work in free. You know, what very conveniently, for us, people call as collaborations, you know, that we will collaborate with you. They don't understand that if you are selling your product through me, it's your profession. So I also have a profession of modeling and acting. Why would I collaborate with you without any money? Yeah. When you are earning money through me, then you should be ready to pay me also some amount of money. True. So these challenges are there, but I'm managing. I'm trying to, align and connect with the best people.
So these are the challenges which should be addressed.
Yes, it's right.
Yeah. So Dinesh, you are a style inspiration from ethnic to street style. You are setting up some style goals, but from whom you take the inspiration?
I'm a very inward looking person. I don't much notice people. Even if you meet me outside in a marketplace, I hardly look at people. My eyes are always down and I hardly notice. But then once in a while you do notice somebody with a very high style quotient, a very different style quotient, and that is from where I draw my inspiration. Even on social media, without sticking to a particular age group, because normally we have this notion that only youngsters have a sense of style. Mm-hmm. And they are, in fashion and they are trendy and all, which is not true. In Western world, if you look even at the people who are beyond 70, they're very stylish. And, so once in a while, you do come across people whom you can, from whom you can learn. So that is where I take my style, this thing from.
Okay. We have seen your work. You have worked in many music films and then in many movies like Bharat and Sand Ki Aankh. So my question to you is, how Sand Ki Aankh happened to you?
Yeah, this industry is a very beautiful place to be in. Yes. And I can very proudly say that till date, and I'm not boasting or anything, till date, I haven't approached anybody that, please give me a role, please take me in your movie, or please take me in your TV commercial or whatever. It's always people who have been coming to me, and I found that you have to be patient, and sit quietly and do your work, then people will notice you. If there is an update of a particular role on Facebook, there are hundreds of people who are writing every day, when will my turn come, when will you take me, please consider me and all that. I have never ever done that. So Sand Ki Aankh, Bharat, Darbar, every movie, and Happy Sardar, Malayalam movies I have done too. Every movie maker approached me himself or herself. And so this is the way Sand Ki Aankh also happened. The casting people approached me, they auditioned me, and I was selected. And before I could understand what I'm getting into, I was taken to Meerut for the first, schedule. And there, on the very first day, I saw two women walk up to me in attire of a village person. And one of them said, "Hi, I'm Bhumi." The other said, "Hi, I'm Tapsi." So things have been happening to me like this.
Yeah. So you got to work with one of the most amazing film director, filmmaker Anurag Kashyap, and the two very talented Tapsi Pannu and Bhumi Bednekar. So please share your experience while working with them.
Anurag Kashyap ji has produced the movie.
Yeah.
And he's not the director of the movie. Director is Tushar Hiranandani. So I found him to be a very calm and, very collected, sensible person and totally into the craft of movie making, and he gave me that confidence that yes, Dinesh, you will be able to pull off your scene, you can do this. And he told me in minute detail what he wanted from me. And by observing Bhumi and Tapsi and Prakash Jha was also a part of the movie, I could see that they were hardly interacting with anybody. They were totally into their characters and trying to memorize their lines, even walking like them, talking like them, even off the set. So they were totally living those roles. So I learned that you have to imbibe a character inside you before portraying that character on screen. So I learned it was a very good training experience for me, that movie. I learned the craft of acting on the sets of Saantian. So I'm actually thankful for those movie makers. Yes.
So that was an amazing experience, I must say.
Yes. Yes, it was.
So any upcoming projects where we would see you?
On Instagram things go on, and there are paid collaborations, and there's no end to designers sending their clothes to me and other stuff. You know, I receive 4 to 5 packets every day and take my time in shooting myself for those projects and all that. So I've recently shot for a phone which is called Easy Phone. Okay. And it's a new phone with a new concept. It's a weekender phone where you can, you know, leave your actual phone at home so that you are not disturbed, and just feed 20 numbers, important numbers, into the other phone, and only those 20 numbers will be able to call you during your weekend and all that. And there is an SOS facility, there is a blacklist, there is a white. It's a beautiful, nice, unbreakable waterproof phone. You can, you know, put it in snow for 2 hours and the phone is still working.
Okay.
And you can put it in muddy water and the phone still works. So I have recently shot myself for that. It will be there on my Instagram very soon. Plus my Bollywood movie that I'm doing on the life of Shaheed Bhagat Singh Ji. Mm-hmm. The second schedule is about to roll now. The first schedule we have already finished in Punjab. And the second schedule is going to happen. And many other projects. I have taken up a fashion show recently, which will happen in Indore in August. So things are looking up now again after the lockdown.
Yeah, so you have a jam-packed schedule lined up.
Yeah, I've always had. I love to work. That is the thing.
So which of work are you extremely proud of?
Saantiyaak. And, you know, but it's very tough to answer this because right from the beginning, you know, yesterday I was sitting and trying to recollect what all projects I have done. And in the beginning of my career, actually, I worked free for many of the filmmakers. You know, there were many projects in Delhi in which they would say, okay, we'll give you lunch of your choice and you just come and shoot.
Yeah.
I don't need lunch because I'm a very well-off person from a very solid background.
Yeah.
But I did that. I went and just ate lunch and did their shoots because I wanted to be successful in this line. I wanted somehow to make a career for myself in this line. So I'm proud of all the jobs that I've done in this industry. I'm equally proud of them.
Yeah. So Dinesh, you are a fitness enthusiast. So what message would you like to convey to our youngsters who are conscious about their health and fitness, about body positivity?
Yeah, exactly. But they are always in a hurry. You know, this is what I have noticed. So they use steroids, all kinds of substances, and they are into drug abuse and this hookah smoking and drinking and, you know, all kinds of things. So I don't like those. You know, aspects of a young person's life, and they are disrespectful towards their elders mostly. It might be workplace or at home. So though they are fitness enthusiasts, they need to be fit here also. They need to be strong here also. So that is what I would like to suggest them, that be more calm here and have good habits in life.
About your educational background or your early days before career you pursued before coming into modeling and before that depression phase, how your life was?
Yeah, it was, we had a wonderful life. I belong to Haryana.
Yeah.
I was born and in Rohtak, and till my 6th standard I studied there. Then my parents, they were both working. I have educated parents, highly educated parents, and they were both educationists and very successful educationists. So then they shifted to Narnol, which is a small village-like area in Haryana, on the border of Rajasthan and Haryana. And then they got shifted to Hisar. Hisar is another place in Haryana, which is a very local people there, and you know, all that. So my schooling and college, and then I shifted to Chandigarh, to Punjab University, Chandigarh, and did my master's here. And I always excelled in my academics. I was always coming first in the university or the class or whatever I did. And my parents were very hopeful that he is going to be the son who is going to be very successful in life. But then sadly, it didn't happen. I had a good job, but I had a very bad personal life, which put me in a lot of, you know, problems and a lot of struggles, which I had not... I don't know how I should put it. I had not seen those problems in my own home. My parents never fought. They were very happy with one another. So whatever happened in my life was very new and very shocking to me. And I had not imagined my life like that, because I wanted to be traveling and to be happy and to have more and more friends in life. And so it, you know, everything went out of my hands, and I lost a lot in that process. And I was, you know, talking to somebody today, because recently there are certain incidents have happened in Bollywood, where, you know, a person is, you know, in police net, and his wife happens to be a star, and, you know, things like that. So entire life, you try to build a reputation for yourself.
Yeah.
Money doesn't matter. It comes and goes. But if your reputation is harmed by people who don't understand you, who don't even know you. Yeah. So those things happened with me.
Yeah.
Nobody bothered who I am, what I am, what my background is. But there were rumor mongers and rumors, and, you know, I felt totally out of place at that time, and totally suppressed and oppressed. So those were very tough circumstances to deal with, because I wanted a respectable life, which I was denied. So, but anyway, that is in the past. It doesn't make any difference.
Yeah.
Now I can proudly say, and even my father is not there, sadly, but my mom is there, and she's very proud that we used to think that you will be the most successful son, and now you are the most successful son. So I'm happy.
So now you are an inspiration to all the people out there. You're inspiring people of all age groups.
That is very important, you know. Money and fame and name and everything is useless. It comes and goes. But this thing that you can, you know, give hope to people to live and to struggle and to fight and to come out as winners. Yeah. If I can give that feeling to somebody, that is the best reward.
Yeah, that's true. That's really true. Recently, we got to see you in Indian Idol. So I would like you to share some experience with us.
Yeah, because I always loved Indian Idol. My mom loves Indian Idol. Everybody in my family watches Indian Idol. And I'm a very chilled out person. As I told you, I've never approached anybody for any work.
Yeah.
So in February this year, I had got a message on Facebook by somebody, some lady who is producer of that program, that are you interested in coming in Indian Idol? I just dropped my phone number and said yes, and then forgot about it, totally forgot about it.
Okay.
And then last month they again approached me. I got a call that we had taken your number and we're now making an episode on successful senior age people. So would you like to come? I said, why not? Why not? Who would not like to go on Indian Idol? So it was a dream come true. So yeah, I had a nice time. They treated me very well. I'm very thankful to this industry that without being a king, they have always treated me like a king. You know, this industry is very kind to successful people.
Yeah. And from king, I remind that you played the role of the Maharaja of Alwar in Sankhyang.
Yes, correct.
Who was very supportive to his wife.
Yeah. Yes, even that is, you know, that is memorable, because we shot that party sequence at my home in Patodi Palace.
Yeah. Yeah.
Patodi Palace belongs to Saif Ali Khan and Kareena Kapoor. So it, and I used to live in Gurgaon at that time, so it was very near my home and I felt at home. And that is the first time I went and saw that palace, and I realized that, okay, I mean, this is Bollywood history, and you know, so I felt very good shooting for that movie.
So, Adinesh, what do you do in your spare time?
I wish I had a lot of spare time like other people. In my spare time, like, I rushed back from a shoot today, and sorry, I had to postpone this meeting from a prior fixed time to this. I just rushed back home, took off my makeup, and you know, went to sleep for half an hour, then got up and had my cup of tea and got ready to face you people.
Okay.
So it's rushing all the time, even in pandemic and lockdown. I'm rushing from one place to other, and you know, shooting all the time.
Yeah. So you are highly active on social media, and the Instagram account you have with the name Silver Fox. So how social media has changed your life, or what role social media plays in your life?
Yeah, see, I've been telling everybody that right from my first shoot, when I went for my very first shoot, I had no idea about selfies or mirror selfies and things like that. They all, you know, became popular terms later on.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking of end of 2015 or maybe beginning of 2016. Mm-hmm. And when makeup was being applied on my face, there was a huge mirror in front of me, and I just clicked myself in that mirror and that lady giving me makeup. And this photograph went viral on social media because everybody was surprised, especially my relatives abroad and here. They made it viral that, okay, Dinesh is up to some mischief, you know, he's getting makeup done, maybe he's getting married or what, and things like that. So from there, I learned that social media is a handle if you are able to excite curiosity in people. On social media, then you will become more and more popular.
Yeah.
And I had nothing, no personal life. Even now, I have no personal life. I express myself fully. I live fully on social media. This is social media is my life.
Yeah.
So I have no one to, you know, nobody has time these days. I have no one to talk to. Jo mere dil mein hai, main kisi ko bata nahi pata. So I express myself on social media. My career is based solely on social media, and from my example, other actors and actresses in Delhi and Mumbai started being more active on social media. People who used to tell me earlier, Dinesh, tum itne social media pe kyon rehte ho? Matlab thoda Bhagwan ka naam bhi liya karo. Now they are more active on social media than me, because everybody realized that social media एक ऐसा टूल है जिससे हम अपने आप को लोगों के सामने पेश कर सकते हैं.
So you are inspiring people in all the fields, like from fashion to social media.
Yes. Yeah. I don't know how this happened, but yes, you're right.
So taking this conversation to an end, my last question to you is, what message would you like to convey to our audience about living the life to its full potential?
See, I always use a word, bindas. It's one of my favorite, most favorite words ever. You know, and सबको मैं हमेशा यही कहता हूँ कि जो डर से जीता है ना, किसी भी डर में, they cannot express themselves fully. चाहे वो आपके relationships का डर हो, breakup का डर हो, माँ-बाप के emotional blackmail का डर हो, आपके friends का डर हो, responsibilities का डर हो, professional डर हो. आप जिस दिन डर की दीवारों से निकल जाते हो ना बाहर, देन यू एक्चुअली स्टार्ट फ्लाइंग इन द स्काई. सो अगर जीवन मिला है और दोबारा नहीं मिलना, एज दिनेश मोहन, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गेट दिस लाइफ अगेन. सो इट्स ओनली नाउ एंड हियर दैट आई कैन एक्सप्रेस माइसेल्फ एंड बी फ्री एंड एंजॉय माई लाइफ. यू नो, द एंटायर पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ, एंटायर पर्पस. सी, I have only two rules in life. The first rule is have a lot of fun, and the second rule is that read the first rule carefully. So
have lots of fun.
niche and have fun. That is the purpose of life.
so it can be said that this is the mantra of your life.
Yes, absolutely. I can laugh in the worst of situations. I have, and people, you know, at times get surprised that in these circumstances, how can you laugh? Yeah.
So, thank you, Dinesh, for being with us today. It was lovely talking to you. It was really fun talking to you. And I wish you all the best for your future endeavors, and keep entertaining, keep inspiring. And wish you
thank
all the
best. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
God bless you for being so nice to me. And God bless everybody who is watching this or who will watch this. Thank you so much. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.